The SpaceX Dragon spacecraft is targeted for launch on May 7th. And to talk about the progress and milestones leading up to launch, we have on the phone with us from the Kennedy Space Center, Mike Horkachuk, who is NASA's project executive for SpaceX. Good morning, Mike. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Well, we appreciate you joining us from the Kennedy Space Center. You're over there monitoring the progress for launch. How are things going?
They're going very well. The hardware's in good shape. In fact, they just put the rocket and capsule on their transporter, and that rolls it out to the pad and tilts the rocket up to vertical, getting ready for launch. So in the last few days, they've done the final closeouts and checkouts of the Dragon spacecraft and fueled the Dragon spacecraft and have a good fuel load. So heading into static fire, the hardware seems to be in good shape.
Okay, let's talk a little more about the static fire. I understand that's scheduled for Monday. What does that involve?
It involves rolling the rocket out to the launch pad, starting fueling and going through the full countdown. So it simulates all the activities leading up to a launch, fully fuels the rocket, and then it actually starts the first stage engines for just a few seconds, make sure that they all work and function correctly. So it runs for about 2 seconds and then shuts off. It'll check out all the automated procedures and software that the vehicle has leading up to the final launch. Since we have an instantaneous launch window for this flight, they want to make sure that everything's working correctly and we don't have any glitches at the last second.
Okay, that's understandable. Are there, I guess that's a week out before launch. Are there any other key milestones leading up to May 7th?
Tonight, in fact, we're having a meeting with SpaceX. It's one of their internal meetings, their flight readiness review and rollout readiness review. So they have all the responsible engineers in the SpaceX company report out how each one of their pieces of hardware and subsystems are doing and their readiness and open work getting ready for launch. So that's a key review leading up to the static fire. And then after static fire, there'll be a lot of data review of how everything worked on the static fire. And then there'll be a final launch readiness review about a day before launch.
It sounds like technically the hardware is getting ready and there's progress towards the launch after it was delayed earlier this week. They had been targeting Monday for launch, but now May 7th is the target, right?
It is. Yeah, there was a lot of review of all the software, and they had just finished up a large number of what they call HIDL, hardware in the loop testing, where they tested the software on simulators as well as on the actual vehicle and made sure that a number of different cases that they had simulated were all working well. So they're spending a lot of time reviewing all that data, making sure that there were no little funnies in any of the activities that resulted from all those different test cases. So that's a large amount of work, and they needed a little bit more time to go look at all that and make sure that all the software was functioning correctly.
Well, that's good to hear that it's going through the process methodically, and you guys have been planning for this mission for a while, and I'm sure you're excited to be at Kennedy and getting ready for the flight. What are you looking forward to most?
Oh, obviously, getting the Dragon spacecraft deployed in orbit. Rocket launches are always a risky business. If it was easy, I guess everybody'd be doing it. But getting the capsule up into space, and then there's a number of new subsystems on the capsule. So this will have solar arrays to be able to collect the sun's energy and help power the spacecraft. Those need to deploy correctly. There's a cooling system that needs to operate. There's some new staging events that are similar to what has happened on the previous missions, but are slightly different interfaces. And then all the software, this is a fully redundant three-string avionics system on this vehicle, making sure that all those components work well together as well as in the space environment. all going to be critical to being able to come in and berth to the space station.
Yes, it sounds like there are several steps along the way that people should stay tuned for and monitor the progress of the mission. And I'm sure we'll hear from you and other folks along the way of how that's going. Thank you for joining us this morning. I'm sure, again, we'll hear from you again here on NASA television, and hope all goes well down there at the Kennedy Space Center.
Thank you. I was looking forward to it.